Hey, what's up, folks? So it's my favorite time of year and probably yours too. We've got show season coming up, but that means we have to keep our cars nice and clean so they're ready to get there at the event and look their best. Griot's also loves this time of year and was happy to partner with us and send us some cool products here that are gonna save you time and make you not have to go to a coin-op wash and wait in line with everybody else. You can go right to the show, spray up, detail your car, and get it nice and shined up. So you're already there. What we've got here in front of us is Griot's hoseless pump up sprayer. So this is basically a foam cannon that's gonna work just the same way, except no air needed, no water hookup needed. Great for somebody on the go, somebody at an event, or even somebody that just doesn't have shop air at their house. We've also got some great wheel cleaner here that comes with a nice little sprayer attachment. So we can do that in our spot here or at the show or wherever we are. And we also have a headlight restoration kit. As you can see, I've got some nice oxidation going on, and this is a really quick way to tackle that without having to bake the headlight open and go through a whole ordeal. So we're gonna show this stuff off and show you how you can get a great detail on the go or at your house where you don't have shop air. So let's check this stuff out and see how well it works on my little Porsche behind me. All right, so what I've got here is Griot's pump up washer. So this doesn't use air, it doesn't use any water hookups, it's all self-contained. You fill it with the foaming polygloss that you can get from Griot's, basically about 0.5 liters, which is handily marked here on the side of the bottle, and then the rest of the way with water. So that's your mixture ratio. And then basically you pump this guy up and you've got pressure right here. It's enough to basically spray down a whole car. It's perfect for somebody on the go or just trying to get a quick wash at home. Especially if you don't have an air compressor or a pressure washer or whatever, this makes it so that anybody can use a foam cannon and get those tasty foam shots. Which is great, you know, especially if you're just doing a nice little surface wash, you're not going in an in-depth detail. This is gonna foam up, sit on the surface nice and well, and kind of collect everything that's there, wipe it down, spray it off, and you're good to go. All right, so clearly that took like a minute or two. I mean, obviously there's a little bit of manual labor involved, but you don't have any shop air. So for somebody on the go, this is perfect. My 911 here didn't use even all of the container. Got a nice, full, even coating over the whole car. We're gonna wipe it down, spray it off, move on to the wheels. We got the car all washed off. Before we dry it, we're gonna clean the wheels with this handy dandy wheel mitt that makes me look like Zoidberg and Griot's wheel cleaner. We're gonna knock this all out, dry it off, and then move on to the headlight. As you can see, we haven't taken up a whole lot of space with all the stuff that we've used, and we haven't needed an air compressor. So this is perfect for somebody that's taking this stuff to a show, doesn't wanna wait on a coin-op car wash, or somebody that doesn't have a compressor at their house. So let's get these wheels knocked out, dry the car off, and move on to the headlight. And it's important to start, as Griot says, from the bottom up. Somebody wants to tell me why that is, I'd love to know. I love detailing, but I actually don't know why you would want to start bottom up. I always do top down when I'm washing my car. All right, so we got it sprayed down. We're gonna let this stuff sit on here for 1 to 2 minutes and then come back, wipe it down, spray it off. You definitely don't want to leave this stuff on paint, on wheels. It'll eat through that stuff. So you want to make sure you're spraying it off. Don't let it dry on there. Additionally, some folks like to do the wheels and tires before they wash the car. I'm kind of an after guy because I'm going to spray it down again anyways. Just make sure I got any remaining little soap scum sitting in the panel gaps or whatever. But if you want to do it the other way, wash your wheels first and then spray them down. No chance of leaving them on the paint and letting it ruin it. So we're going to wipe this guy down and clean off the rest of these wheels. Oh, this mitt is handy to get in here behind the spokes, clean the brake caliper off. A little more time consuming than a brush, but I feel like I'm doing a better job. Also, brushes kind of scare me about scratching wheel paint. Lug wells. All right, now we can spray it off. Make sure that stuff doesn't dry on the paint. All right, perfect. Nice shiny wheel, like brand new, except for the little dings and stuff, but don't worry about that. Cool, so finally on to restoring the slight oxidation that I've got going on here with my headlights with Griot Ceramic Headlight Restorer. This stuff is gonna be pretty quick to install. The really time-consuming bit is masking off your headlight. You just don't wanna get any of this stuff on your paint. If you do, wipe it off immediately. We've already done one, and now we're gonna move on to this guy and make it shine just like brand new. So this is something that's gonna affect pretty much all your modern cars with plastic headlight housings. You're gonna have to deal with oxidation at some point. If you take care of it before it gets really bad, you're not gonna have to go through a whole bunch of tedious work. So we're trying to stop this right now and then protect it with the ceramic coating. Once we're done, we'll basically let it sit for about an hour, make sure it stays nice and dry and out of the elements, and then it's cured and good to go. So we'll go ahead and knock this out and you can follow along and watch me clear this headlight up. So this is basically just gonna wipe on pretty much like any kind of protective coating that you've done. We're gonna start top to bottom. Keep some mild pressure on it. We're gonna see this thing start to turn yellow as it picks up all the oxidation in this. We're gonna let it dry, and then we're gonna ceramic coat it, and then let that cure for about an hour. So this should be, I don't know how dramatic this is gonna be on camera, but this should be pretty noticeable as this thing cleans up. Now for a full instructional video on how to use these, Griot has DIY instruction videos on basically every single product that they make and sell, which is incredibly helpful if you, you know, are just trying to get started and keeping your car perfect. Oh yeah, I can feel that roughness. It actually feels like it's smoothing out a bit. This guy. All right, so we've done our first stage, which was the oxidation remover. And in between that and our ceramic headlight coating that we're about to apply, highly recommend that you do some polishing. Griot has a really good DIY video on their website that we'll link in the description below this video. Basically, you're just gonna do a three-stage sandpaper wet sand, going from 1,000 to 3,000 grit, and then maybe hit with a little polishing compound in between there just to get it a nice, perfect prep surface. And we're gonna go ahead and apply our ceramic headlight coating. And I can already tell a really, you know, noticeable difference. You know, a lot less yellow from that oxidation. Definitely a clearer headlight. But basically all we're gonna do is start at the top and do one coat, left to right, basically 50% overlap. We're not gonna do multiple passes. We're not trying to over-apply it. We're not trying to put pressure, just glide this puppy on here. Coat the whole headlight. And we're done. Well, I am really impressed with the results on this. I gotta say, I was skeptical at the get-go. You know, quick fixes, hit or miss. You know, I've definitely tried some things and been really unhappy with the results. This is not one of those cases. I am thrilled right now. I was very scared taking some cutting compound and sanding my headlight, but I went from a yellow headlight to a clear headlight that looks brand new, just like the other side, and it really didn't take much more than a little bit of elbow grease. Pro tip, if you have an Orbital, definitely worth having to kind of get up that nice polish in between. But man, 5 out of 5 Craigs, would have all of this stuff in my garage. Can't wait to use that pump up foamer this summer for car show season. And now I don't have to show up looking like a goof with mismatched headlights. All right, well, we have cleaned up my Porsche here and we'll let this headlight cure while that finishes. We'd like to thank our friends over at Griot's for sending us these awesome new toys to play around with. I know that our show season is about to be a lot more fun, being able to use our pump up sprayer and Griot's foam spray and get some details at a show instead of having to go to CoinOp. Now I've got some nice clear headlights thanks to their ceramic restoration kit. And we have nice, shiny, clean wheels with the Griot's wheel cleaner and Zoidberg wheel cleaning mitts. So again, thank you to Griot's for helping us out with this and helping me fix my headlight. And you guys can find all this stuff and the rest of Griot's catalog in the description of the video below. Thanks, bye.